All right, if you have a 1973 Eisenhower dollar or Ike dollar, definitely watch this whole video. Let's just hop into it and see what these coins are actually selling for and what you should be looking for on your Eisenhower dollars that can make them valuable. All right, so first off, starting with the 1973, now this is the S mint mark, and it's going to be the proof silver dollar, Eisenhower dollar. So first off, you want to look for doubling on the phrase "In God We Trust." We can see that doubling here on the lettering of the coin, and here's another example of that as well taking place on the 1973 S dollar coin. Now here is that coin that actually sold with that double die obverse. Now you see on the coin slab, graded by PCGS, it's graded at a proof 70 deep cameo. So the coin grading scale goes up to 70, this is graded at a 70, so it's a perfect graded coin. So it's as high as it can get on the coin grading scale. Now this coin is silver as well, and this coin sold for over $2,500. So $2,500. Now here is a silver 1973 S, but this, however, is not the proof coin. So there's a silver proof and a silver business stripe. So this is graded at a MS69, Mint State 69, which is a very high grade, like I said before, and that's what's gonna make the coin super valuable. Now this coin sold for over 5,000 US dollars. Now if you have one of these coins and it's not in the best condition, you know it's not gonna sell anywhere near for $5,000. It's really depending on the grade when you sell the coin, how many are graded at a Mint State 69 or perfect grade at the time that you sell it. Things of that nature all determine the coin's value. Now here we go, a 1973 S. Again, this is the silver proof, graded at a perfect grade. It does not have the double die obverse. It just has that amazing perfect grade deep cameo, and that's why the coin sold for over $12,000. Now, if we look at the Eisenhower dollar from 1973, this is the no mint mark, and this is, you know, not the proof coin, so it's not the proof, and it's solely valuable, again, because of the high grade. So this coin here sold for over $2,500, $2,500 US dollars. Now, if you would like me to review your coins and get my feedback on your coins, you can become a level 2 or a level 3 member by pressing the blue join button on my channel, and then you can email me up to 10 coin pictures a month and get my opinion on whether or not you should get them graded or if you have any types of errors or things like that. Now, the next coin is pretty similar to the last coin. It's graded at a Mint State 67, but this is the D mint mark, and this coin sold for over $12,000. So typically, if you have one of these Eisenhower dollars, they're not gonna be, you know, high grades, you know, especially if they've been circulated, they got little scratches nicked up, and that's really gonna devalue them a lot. So keep that in mind. This coin, again, is very high grade, $12,000. Now check out these other dollar coins that you should always, always be on the lookout for. Here is a picture of the 1979 Susan B. Anthony dollar. Now there's two types to look for. You got the narrow rim and the wide rim. The narrow rim is the picture up top, the wide rim down there at the bottom. Now if we look at the bottom image and we look at the date 1979, you can see how close the bottom of the date, like say for instance the one and the nine there, the first 19 of 1979, you see how that's almost touching the rim there. Whereas up top, you can see that the rim is more narrow and the date is farther away. So the wide rim is more scarce, the one you kind of want to look for, and the narrow rim is the more common one. Now here's an example of a 1979 Susan B. Anthony dollar that has that wide rim. Now of course this has a very high grade as well, so that's what's going to give it most of its value. Now this coin here sold for over $6,400. Now I'm going to show you one that isn't graded as high, but it's still graded at a Mint State 64 with the wide rim. So you can really see the difference from Mint State 64 to Mint State 67. You go from over $6,000 to this coin only selling for $60. So that grade is extremely, extremely important. If you're not familiar with coin grading, I have a whole coin grading video on my channel. Next up is a 2007 presidential dollar coin. Now this is a high graded coin as well, graded at a Mint State 66, but it also has the missing edge lettering. I know you see the design of the coin right now, but on these coins they have lettering on the edge. So if you were to turn this coin sideways and look there all the way on the edge of the coin, you'd see that lettering. However, some of them are missing the lettering, and that's what will give the coin some value as well. Now this coin here sold for over $2,500. All right, now here is an Eisenhower dollar coin. All right, so this is just like a stock image of a coin. I wanna show you the different weights between a non-silver Eisenhower dollar and a 40% silver clad Eisenhower dollar. So you could see the difference in weight there. The copper nickel clad is 22.68 grams and then the 40% silver clad is 24.624 grams. All right, so keep that in mind because you wanna weigh your coins to know this next type of error. And you can weigh your coins by getting a coin scale on couchcollectibles.com. Link's always in the description. All right, so here it is, a 1976 Denver minted Eisenhower dollar. Now what makes this coin valuable is that it was struck on a 40% silver planchet. Now it was not supposed to be struck on a 40% silver planchet. Now this thing has been circulated. You see it's only graded at an AU55, so not a mint state of grade or anything like that. So someone did come across and find this thing. Now this coin sold for over $8,000, an $8,000 $1 coin. All right, so this coin here, this guy actually received this from the bank. All right, it's a Susan B. Anthony dollar design that is struck on a Sacagawea dollar planchet. So very, very cool. You guys know what Sacagawea dollars are, I'm assuming. They got that gold colorish like color, and that's why we got, you know, the Susan B. Anthony design here on a gold looking coin. Now, this coin here is very, very valuable. This coin sold for over $10,000. $10,000. So if you guys have any coins with like weird different types of colors, I have a whole video on where to sell your coins, where to post images of your coins and get feedback from other collectors. So be sure to just type in how to sell your coins on YouTube and you'll be able to find my video. All right, so in 1921, they produced over 85 million of the 1921 combined with the 1921D and 1921S mint mark Morgan dollar. So all three of those combined, they produced over 85 million, so they produced a lot of those coins. All right, so first off here, we have an extremely high-graded version of the 1921 Denver minted Morgan dollar. Now, these dollar coins are extremely, extremely valuable because of their high grades. So this is like almost a perfect grade. The coin grading scale only goes up to 70. This is mint state 67, and this coin sold for over $27,000. All right, so next up is another 1921 Denver minted Morgan dollar. This one here, it's got some nice toning to it. It's graded at a mint state 67, and it sold for over $44,000. Now keep in mind, guys, if you guys do have a 1921 Morgan dollar, and it's all scratched up and beat up, and it's worn down, it's not gonna sell for these prices, but let's look at some other stuff that can make it even more valuable. All right, so this next one is interesting and weird. It's pretty sweet though. So if we zoom in there to the front of the coin, you can see that it has an engraving. And what that is on this 1921D is that it was the third coin released from the first 100 coins at the Denver Mint. So that is extremely, extremely rare. This coin here sold for over $13,000. Moving right along to a 1921S. Keep in mind, this is a very high graded coin as well, mint state 67. That's what gives it a lot of value, and this coin here sold for over $19,000. Now, moving right along to a 1921S that has a thorn head. So we're gonna look at what exactly that is. This is graded here at about uncirculated 53, so it's not a mint state grade, so a little lower, but it's still sold for thousands of dollars. And there are a ton of different VAMs of these coins. I'm not gonna go into all that because we would be here all day if we went through all the 1921 VAMs. So here is an example of the thorn head that takes place on this 1921 Morgan dollar. So what that is that is a die gouge. Now, this coin, because of that die gouge, that thorn head on this coin, it sold for over $7,000. Moving right along, here's a 1921S. It's graded at an AU50, about uncirculated 50, so even a lower grade. Now, this also has the thorn head. You can see it's not in as great as condition as the other ones, and it sold for a little over $300. So you go from thousands of dollars to 300 really quick. All that depends especially on the grade of the coin. All right guys, until tomorrow, don't forget to subscribe in the middle, check out the videos to the left of me, and until then, I will see you on the comment section below. This is Couch Collectibles, and this is where I disappear.